Hi everyone and welcome back to the course. In this video, I will show you how you can create a summarization application for Microsoft Word. So what is going to be the difference between the application that we'll create today and the applications that we created so far? Well, the main difference is that in this case, we'll create an application that any user can install inside its device and use it locally. Unlike our previous examples where we had to deploy the application to a cloud platform and then run it in a website. So let's jump into it, create a Python project, and I'll give you a brief description on what is our application going to do. So let's write PyCharm, and here I'll create a new project, and let's call this project Word Summarizer. Okay, so here is your project, and the idea is that your application will open a Word file that the user select, and then it will take all the text from this Word file and it will give you the summarized text in just a few sentences. That way the user don't need to read the whole Word document in order to get the idea, but instead can simply read the two sentence summary and be familiar with all the information. So let's create a new Python file, and I'll call it main. And here we're going to use two libraries. One of them is going to be the OpenAI library, so let's do import OpenAI, while the other one is going to be the library that works with Word documents. And yes, Python has libraries that can automatically open and deal with Word. So this library is called docx. Now also, in order to create the user interface of your application, you need to import tkinter, so let's do import tkinter as tk. And then let's do from tkinter, we're going to import file dialog. Now let's go to the terminal and install all of those libraries. So I will do pipe install openai, then let's do pipe install python-docx. And this is actually everything that you need to install, since the tkinter is one of the standard Python packages, so it's already installed in your virtual environment. Now the next step is to create a function that is actually going to summarize your text. And for that, we're going to use the OpenAI API, and we'll use ChatGPT to do that in the background. So let's do it. Let's do def summarize text, and then I'll write here file location. So we'll pass the file location to this function, and then this application should read the document, take the information, and then send it to the OpenAI. So let's do now doc equals to docx dot document, and then I will pass the file location. That way our function will take the specific document that the user selects. Next, let's write text, okay, and initially this will be an empty string, and after that let's do for para in doc dot paragraphs text plus equals para dot text. So what we're doing here is the following. So we are taking each paragraph from our document. So in the Word document, the text is structured into different paragraphs. And then we are saying for every paragraph in the document, add this paragraph to our text. So now after this line here, our text variable has all the attributes from the Word document. So it has the complete text of your document. Now the next step would be easy, and you should be already familiar on how to do it. You simply call the OpenAI, and firstly you set the API key, okay, and this is my API key. So if you don't know how to obtain this key, you can watch the first section of this course. Then we will define the model, so let's do model underscore engine, then let's do text dash DaVinci dash 003, then let's do response will be equal to OpenAI dot completion create, and here we are going to create the code to the API. So let's do engine will be equal to our model engine variable. So here we will be able to choose which model we want. And as you can see, we are currently using DaVinci 003, which is the most powerful GPT-3 model. Then let's do prompt equals to summarize the following text into sentences. Okay, then what I want to do is to pass the text, so let's do plus, and I'll pass the text in parentheses, so let's do plus, and then the text variable, okay, and then let's also add another parenthesis on the other side, great, then let's do max underscore tokens equal to 1000, then let's do comma n equal to 1, And let's paste comma here as well. Then the stop will be equal to none. And finally, the temperature will be equal to 0.8. Okay, so our API call is ready. So now let's extract the text from the response. And here we're going to get the summarized text. So let's do summarize text equals to response choices at position 0. And then we'll take the text. And finally, I will return the summarized text. So the idea of this whole function is that we pass the file location and then we output from the function our summarized text. Pretty simple. So you did the more complicated part, guys, and in the next video we're going to create our actual application using the TK inner, so you will be able to run it on your local machine. Thanks for watching.